Hi there, welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie and it's great to have you here. Today I want to show you how you can create ratios in Microsoft Excel. Ratios are a great way to quickly analyze your data and see the relationships between certain numbers. So if you're able to put in a couple numbers like this, I can show you using different functions and formulas how to get this as an output here, and you can easily copy this down. I want to show you two different ways that you can create ratios in Microsoft Excel today on Teachers Tech. So the first way I want to show you is using the GCD function. Now, this function is the greatest common divisor, and I'm going to separate this out. It's not going to be just one formula that we're going to create here with the function. We're going to do a multi-step one here. So I'm going to find the greatest common divisor between these two. So I'm just going to put in the equal sign here, and I'm just going to start typing GCD, and there it is, returns the greatest divisor. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. It's going to be the number one is this one right here. So I'm just going to add my comma, and then I'm going to go to number two and hit enter. So between these two numbers, the greatest common divisor is 10. And I can quickly copy this down. I'm just going to go ahead and double click on that green little square and fill it in. And you can see the greatest common divisor between all these. So now I just need to create a formula, and I'm going to relate to this cell here. So let's go ahead and start it. So we're going to put the equal sign in, and it's going to be this A2 divided by the GCD here, so this one. Now we want to have the colon come up. So to do this, I'm going to use the ampersand sign to be able to put this in. So the ampersand sign is this one right here above my number 7. And then I'm going to go ahead and use my quotation marks. And what do I want to be put in between the two of these is going to be the colon. And then I'm going to put my quotation mark again in another ampersand sign, just like that. So I'm not quite done now because I still have to do this part right here. So the next part is going to be this number B2 divided by this again. So we have our formula already. All I have to do is hit enter, and you can see now I have the ratio of 5:2, and I can flash fill this down. I'm just going to go ahead, and you can see as it goes through, it has all the correct ratios to all of these right through here. Now, the next step I want to show you is going to be using the substitute function and the text function. So as I mentioned, I'm going to use the text function and the substitute function. So the text function is going to convert a value to text and format it, kind of similar to custom formatting in Excel. Still, the text is a function, so I can still use it with formulas and combine it with other functions. So let's go ahead and start this here. And I'm going to start with the text, and then I'm going to add the substitute function. You'll see what I'm trying to substitute. So I'm going to go ahead, put equals, and I'm just going to go and open up the text function and start. So what do I want to have for my value? Well, my value is going to be this number divided by, so it's A2 divided by B2. So I'm going to put my comma, and this is where I'm going to put, tell it the format, what I want, and it's going to be a division format. I can't go and put the ratio format, it wouldn't understand what that is, but I can convert this with the substitute function that I'll show you. So I need to go ahead and put my quote marks here, and I'm going to put the number sign to show this formatting here, and then put another number sign, and then just put another quotation mark, and then I'm going to hit enter. So you can see at this point, it just gives me back a 5 division 2 with the division sign here in between. So this is where I want to add the substitution to it. So I'm going to make a modification to this one here. I'm going to go in front of it, and I'm going to start typing substitute, and you see it pop open right here. So I'm just going to add it. The text is going to be embedded in here. I'm just going to go to the outside here, and this is where I'm going to say what I want to substitute. Now I need to have a comma here, and I'm going to use my quotation marks, and I'm going to put this division sign is what I want to substitute. What do I want to substitute this with? So I'm going to put a comma. Well, I want to substitute it with the colon. So I just need to use my quotation marks again and then put in the colon and go ahead. And then I'm going to go and close this up and hit enter. So now I have this in the correct format that I wanted, and I can copy this all the way down. So if I just go ahead and fill everything, you can see I get the same results of the first one in just using this one step. So I started with the text function in this case, and then substituted in where I want it to be the change of the division sign to the colon to get my ratio. So these are two different ways that you can create ratios in Microsoft Excel. Let me know if you have any other different methods down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.